Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to read a very interesting and a latest story, and its title is An X for Christmas. This story is for adults. So let's we start to read chapter 1. As we all know, reading can improve our English. So let's start to read this story and try to improve our English. Wow, Christmas season. Choose your look. I think this is good. And now hairstyle. This one is good. My look is great. Let's go. Kelly, what should I select? I should select the Kel. It's Christmas time and I have got the holiday vibes running through my veins. Maybe it's because I spend my weekdays teaching 8-year-olds. But I am excited for carols and hot chocolate. I also like hot chocolates too much. You know, carols used to be sung in all seasons. But only the Christmas tradition carries on. Hello, Kel. I have been waiting for you for some time now. I have never seen this woman before. How does she know my name? Have we met? Of course not. The universe has never sent me to you before. Oh my God. It's too interesting. Sent you to me? I don't understand. I have a message that you must hear. You seek love? Yes. You seek real love, like the one your mother and father share. You are a good daughter to send them on a cruise for their anniversary. What a wonderful Christmas present. Who told you about that? 30 years in love, yes? Yeah. It will be a magical year for them, but I'm here to share news about your life. The one you seek, your true love, you already met him. Oh my God, here at the station? You let him go, but he will come back to you before Christmas. Clearly, you haven't met my exes. The universe does not lie. Oh my God, she's telling about universe. And बहुत सारी predictions पे predictions हो रही हैं यहाँ, काफी interesting है. That's me. Hope you have a merry cree. She vanished. Oh my God. Nice metro. Will I really spend Christmas with my true love? Something, something. Then that lady really does have the sight like my grandmother did. But sometimes fate needs a little help. Good thing I have a plan. Wow, snowfall. I'm so lucky to move, sorry, to have Mark as not only a neighbor, but also a lifelong best friend. He really came through for me when I got the job in Manhattan. I would have been forced to give up my dog if Mark hadn't offered to watch him during the week. Jingle bells, so sweet. Rigby, where are those sloppy cannon kisses? I have been looking forward to one all day. Now, this look is good. Here is also good. Sheila. Practically your New Year's Eve kiss. It's not even Christmas yet. Hey, you can never start practicing too early. That kiss is the first thing you will do in the year. New Year is the last thing I would like to think about right now. You two behave. No fighting until after I leave. Really? Because what I saw didn't look like you were. Sheila, really, I was just saying goodbye. Rigby, there's my good boy. No wonder you didn't run for me right away. Did Santa come early for you this year? Well, I will see Yakel. Sheila. Don't go, I will leave. Fine by me. Mark, stop it. I have got to get to the airport anyways. Oh, I thought you had family coming to town this year. My dad decided that it was too cold this year, so I am visiting him in Atlanta instead. Do you need a ride to the airport? I barely know Sheila, but I like her. I don't want her to feel weird about me being here with Mark. It's the least I can do after raining down my Christmas joy on Mark and interrupting your afternoon. I am good. Thanks, though. Have a good Christmas. I will think of you all freezing up here in New York while I'm with my dad in Atlanta. You too. Safe travels. Here, he looks upset that I interrupted things with Sheila. I should scold Mark for not locking the door. Do you want to drink this beer or wear it? Are you sure you graduated from kindergarten?
because your manners are terrible sometimes. Look, who's talking? Most people say thank you when someone hands them a drink. Thank you, but you still shouldn't have locked the door. How was I supposed to know you were going to barge in here unannounced? Well, in my defense, I figured you would be running your restaurant on Friday afternoon since you are the head chef. In my defense, it's my house, yours is next door. And in my defense again, my dog is here. Your dog, he's practically mine. Oh, since he's at my house more than yours. Okay, we have shared custody. Can we talk about something else now? Sure, from your tone, it sounds like you have something specific in mind. I do. Something happened to me today. Wow, great story. Mark, let me guess, you won the Nobel Peace Prize. Don't be ridiculous. Okay, more realistic. You got puked on at school by a kid who ate too many Christmas cookies. Looks like you are a psychic too. I don't need a psychic to see dried cookie mash on your shoes. Right, guess I missed that. Who's this other side? Psycho. Okay, I'm going to tell you something, but I need you to promise not to roll your eyes. I'm absolutely never promising that. Oh, he's very naughty. Isn't that unbelievable? We have to celebrate. Why would we celebrate that a random woman guessed some things about you in her tea leaves? It wasn't tea leaves. She approached me and knew specific things about me before giving me a reading. She could have seen you in the station before, overheard a phone conversation. But he told me things about him, specific things. Who? My one true love? Have you even been listening? A biggest eye roll ho raha hai, huh? I have to make sure. Why do I get the feeling? I do. So spell it. What's the superstition? Fate is not a superstition. It's cosmic wisdom. Oh, really? वैसे faith and superstitions में difference तो है. My ex-list. Ex-list, please tell me. That's not what I think it is. It's exactly what you think. I'm going to make a list and reconnect with all of my ex-boyfriends. Oh my God. Before Christmas, seriously? I have the next 2 weeks off, so I have plenty of time to execute my plan before then. I have met all of these guys before, Kel. You are wasting your time. Oh. They could have changed. Obviously, everyone can have changed. I don't know. They don't deserve a second glance. So, who would you recommend then? You want me to pick one of your old boyfriends for you to end up? Oh my God, yes. Like I said before, none of them are the right fit for you. Then what kind of guy would you choose in general? Mark laughs and shakes his head. Interesting story hai kafi. Forget the candy canes. A great sense of humor. Oh, I don't know any guys like that. None who? Not anyone who is in my league, that's for sure. But why she is blushing? Sorry to hear that you feel that way. I'm not looking for pity, Mark. Just some support for my idea. It can be your Christmas gift to me. Are you sure that's what you really want for Christmas this year? Cause I can think of some better things. Thank you so much for watching. If you like, don't forget to thumbs up. And we will meet soon with another chapter, that is chapter 2 of this story. So bye bye, have a good day and Merry Christmas in advance.